You want to blow that up?
Well, yeah.
Well, I mean, you probably want the other end first, don't you?
Wow, that is thin. You should do all right. Cool.
Mixed in it, you know.
There is a pound of zinc, and it's not even a cup. It's like 2/3 of a cup. I like the way this was coming out, and it was almost finished, but I did something stupid. I put the hole downs for the stock outside of the cut area, so it cut the piece free before it was done finished, you know, cutting it. So I needed to put the screws in back in this area. Oh well. So if you get in a hurry, use 5-minute epoxy to glue two boards together. Crazy glue works well too. You don't have to stick with wood glue. We're trying something new. Let me show you this. There's a V-carve cut, and we moved the bit 15/1000ths lower than we really want it, and then we filled it with Bondo. We went to dinner, so it's dried. Now we're going to try and come back to zero and cut it, so we hope we leave a little layer of smoother Bondo in there rather than the fur that you get with the MDF.
It might work.
Well, if we actually clamp down, I think it might be all right. We moved our board somehow, so. But this wasn't even clamped down, so we knew this possibly could happen. But what's nice is it is cutting it fairly good. Okay, we're going to do this same experiment with this 5-minute epoxy.
Everything. I'm like, where did all that extra...
Now we'll let that dry up.
Good guess. Yeah, I already turned them on.
Might as well take the time to round out these things too.
A zipper hole for the water to go through as it goes down the deck. That one gets welded to the pipe.
Right.
This one doesn't.
Fits now.
All right, check it out, see? So you should always wear your safety glasses, which is, ow. Yeah, nice.
sorry about that.
Yeah, no apology needed. I think I'll move a little further away from you though. Look at that. That is epoxy cut back out of the letter. And what we did is we raised up, what, 15/1000ths? Is that right?
Yep.
So we cut it 15/1000ths deeper than it is now, filled it with epoxy, backed it out 15/1000ths, so we leave 15/1000ths layer of epoxy. And that's cutting it really slow. I mean, this is like, what, 19 inches
like
per minute?
Well, it's 10%.
10% of 80, so it's only 8 inches per minute. So real, real slow. We sped it up, it did these, and they can be, you know, cleaned up, but that one didn't need any cleanup. So that's the answer. And look at that nice, silky, smooth epoxy finish everywhere. That should pull out of the sand easier, so.
That was gonna be pretty cool.
very much.
This came from Jacob.
Thank
so
you.
So we got a Union Jack, and what'd you call that again?
Royal Standard.
The Royal,
Royal
Standard.
Standard. That one I don't see much, but that, of course.
This Sononi flies.
This one.
Yeah.
Palace.
Yeah.
And my router is doing something really weird. That my machine, for some reason, went insane. And when we, you know, brought it back to zero and tell it to do the cut again, it started about an eighth of an inch over from where it was supposed to be. So I don't know if that's a, I don't think that's a problem with Mach 3, because I've never had that happen before. But it's the first time I was using a V-bit carving path off of, it still doesn't make sense why it would go to a different place. It starts at zero both times.
We have this idea that it's based, we let the whole pattern do again, and it came right back to zero, zero. So we have this idea that it's because we interrupt the cut.
Yeah, figured it out.
There it is, there's the dot, and there's where the tip ended up. So what we did wrong was we interrupted the cut path, and it was on a real fast movement over to the other deal, and that's where we hit escape, and that's where it lost that. So okay, so it'll work fine if we just don't interrupt the cut path, and I have him to thank for this, his idea, not mine. Power of the internet. Teamwork. It was running at 80 inches per minute, so it could be mechanical. When we shut it down, it just had the momentum to force the motor to turn.
I wonder, because it's a gear on teeth. I wonder if
and a belt, and then another two pulleys and a rack and pin.
Yeah, I wonder if it has enough momentum.
Oh, it
to,
does.
To
I
leap
can
over.
I can take that and I can push it even when it's turned on. But I'm overriding those stepper motor magnets.
Yeah,
it takes a lot, but that's a big
that
motor and it was moving fast.
That might have.
So if we had just slowed it down or done it when it was doing something soft and a Z movement.
Well, and that's why we saw it only a little bit when we was in the dragon, because it doesn't happen.
And we shut it down the same time, both of them, which is why we
that's
always
why
saw.
That's consistent.
Yeah.
All right.
So.
Always room for one more clamp there, isn't there?
Yes.
it's oozing through right there. Bart laid down and got a spider bite.
God.
Oh my God, that thing's huge. It's not. It doesn't look like it's rotting. How much painful is
no,
that?
It's tender, but it's. I mean, I've been squeezing the crap out of it.
Yeah, it looks like it's skinned over.
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, but that is a big, big bump.
It's sticking out twice that far Thursday morning.
Is that right? That is a beautiful machine. This is Nathan's Triumph that he came down from Michigan on. Anybody recognize the symbols there on the bags? Huh? He's a burner. All right, good ride home.
It's a water bucket.
Hey, we're gonna give Doug all the wood for the boat. She said, what boat? I said, honey, the ship he's building. She's like, oh, that's Doug. She said, oh, his dog bit attacked me.
No
not
way.
The shepherd you have, the dog before that. Remember the reddish color?
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. Yeah.
You got that on film. No way! Oh yeah, well, oh yeah, she okay.
Was, she was like this tall. And
yeah, yeah.
No.
Oh, she was laughing like crazy.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, look, let me show you where the walnut is.
Stick it, Mill.
That was a cherry log, grew in Tulsa.
I think we're looking at doing everything for the countertops and the pilot house.
Brass?
That's brass, I believe, right?
Oh,
anybody okay. need a cross for the top of your church there?
This came off of the convent in Broken Arrow.
Really?
This was 120 foot high. We took this off, and I'm going to show you the other section that this sat on top of. Maybe one of your viewers might want to have a beautiful eclectic attachment to their backyard. This was blessed by the bishop.
No kidding.
Before we took it down. You know, like when they built the church. You can't, this is 16 inches. And I have some in here that are 18 inches wide.
That is beautiful.
This was cut on a sawmill just like that one right there.
3-year-old walnut.
Okay, but we will find tons of solid wood in there. But here's the deal about this stuff.
Yeah.
It's all short.
Yeah.
But it's easy to work with.
Because you can move it around by hand easy.
Yeah, and sometimes in your boat, you don't need 16-foot pieces.
No, I don't. I piece it all together. In fact, shorter is probably better because we don't have flat walls like houses do.
Yeah,
we have curves.
Yeah.
Get him! Get him!
Show the world some beauty here.
Oh my goodness!
Oh my God!
Would you get a carousel or
this
that came out of the church?
Chandelier to the center rotunda. It took us a week to get this down. A week. By time we had to rig it through the roof We cut a hole through 12 inches of concrete, rebar and everything, to get this lowered in the 40 foot high rotunda about.
Yeah, it's got recessed lighting in it.
It's got a dove in the brass. It's just spectacular dove. Okay, 8'6". Weighs about 1,000 pounds.
This,
we can ship
what's
it
this,
anywhere.
What's this dove?
It can go anywhere.
To hang from that walkboard over there.
We got 8 of these, all glue lambs, all engineered. Okay, and these came back from Gatlinburg, Tennessee. These were the bridge that was built in the Dennis Bowles mansion. He's the guy who stole the $35 million or $30 million and is in prison.
Really?
This was his bridge.
That's a good story.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, wait till I show you the rest. I have 100 totes full of marble over at the tree farm of unbroken pieces.
Oh, that's all right.
This is from the convent.
This came out of the convent.
I have 5 different. This was the walls. There is probably $3 million worth of marble when they built the place that they probably had to spend. Pink,
beige,
white, green, red, beige.
All out of the same convent?
All out of the same convent. This is the round end where that cross goes.
Right.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's beautiful.
See how spectacular that is?
Oh, that was beautiful.
And then there's the other steeple. That one's like 20 foot, right? Are you going to have a cannon on there, Doug?
Absolutely, we're going to have a cannon.
Okay, good.
Who would go to sea without a cannon?
He needs to make a special cubby hole for RPGs. Stick them, hide them down in there.
Yeah.
Pull them out.
Drop a tree on it?
That's where the tree fell on it, yeah. Yep.
Well, I didn't know that, but I can guess, given your line of work.
Yeah. Came right apart.
Is it
Look
copper?
At those trees. No, it's aluminum.
Really? You got 10 of them.
Yeah, 10 of these trees.
That's cool.
That is cool.
First thing
what you do when I met you, you said, I have this house that burned down. Go get the lumber out of it you need. It's up in the attic of my shop.
What'd you get?
No, the 2x4s.
Wow, yeah.
You go up in my attic and you can see
that happened
you can see charred wood up there. Yeah.
He had it. He was fortunate. He had it.
Yeah, I just took that. Like I thought I'd just put loose sand in and push it in.
Right. Do it this way,
but if we did it that way,
fix that down and then
pack it like
pack
that
the hell out of the sand, that'll even give you these divots for the bolts.
Then we turn it over and it comes,
this should
this
go,
goes
go out.
This goes out
right.
Yeah, right. Green sand in high school, everybody does green sand in high school, and they say, why don't you use green sand? It's a pain in the ass.
Well, that's set up for production.
Like they had it sitting around. I don't want to have it sitting around on a boat. But if I could have this, then I could just take that out onto a beach, pack it up with sand, and I wouldn't care about the artwork then. That's kind of a separate thing, is trying to get this to work.
Easy. Move slow. Move real slow. Everything can be tripped over. Do not breathe smoke.
Is it
following me around the pot?
There's nothing on this job that's hazardous.
No, all this is terribly safe.
There's nothing on this job that's healthy.
It's all terribly safe.
All terribly safe,
Just like
you go a little faster if you would. Step a little bit away from that post. There you go. Watch the level.
Good.
I want to pop in around that one over there.
Okay.
That's good. Okay.
Well done. Very lunchtime.
Good. Yeah.
You can go ahead. I'm far enough back now. There you go.
It didn't blow up. It didn't blow up like they usually do.
Who's got the tea bags?
They dumped it right off. There you go.
These are our new rugged field devices.
Okay, that's good. This way. Now it's done. Ah, there it comes. It finally broke. Right there. Okay. Okay, I'm pouring. Thank you. I know. I'm sorry. That's good. Take a breath. We don't have to do anything until we lift it.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Six yesterday, 10 today. No, 12 today. We only need to do 10 tomorrow.
I let the ingot sit in there for about 15 minutes.
Yeah, it's still warm. Kind of hot.
Yeah.
Turn that and mix it up even.
Those are mugs.
Beth?
Have a couple of muffins to put
in. Is that okay there?
That's fine, sir. Thank you. Okay, that's it.
All done. 28 of them.
God, you guys gonna get? Did you put a level on that?
You betcha I will.
We need a laser leveling thing.
Go get it.
Hey, David. There he goes.
Oh, is that what that means?
Why aren't you using a straight edge?
Because I'm lazy.
See, an idea for you when you're welding something that's really thin wall like this pipe to a heavy plate is weld into the plate and just kind of let the puddle touch the pipe. That way you don't put a lot of heat into it. You won't blow through it. Otherwise, you'd blow through that instantly. And over here, what he did is he took the where the bolt holes were and welded down through the hole and just let it come up and flow over the top of that lighter weight plate. Works great.
Okay, that's the line we want to cut along. And that's the angle we want to cut at. So we just got to...
out there. Check the belt when you bring it down on the crane. There it goes.
It broke the head of the screw off. How strange. It's not too drilled too small. It's not drilled big enough.
Wow. This is going to be a learning curve on this stuff. Take some more thinking.
Oh shit. Now there's a lesson learned. This has to be set back in because it has to clear this slant. Oh well. Good at it by the time we're doing the last one.
They have to be set back in so that they miss that slope. Bart and Paul suggested waxing it. We're gonna wax it. See what that does. I don't know. It didn't break it. One down. Here's,
but it's done.
Oh, yeah.
All right, yeah, that did it. Beautiful.
So then we just say that is the right length.
Yeah.
So since these boards are already countersunk, we're just going to turn the countersink cloth around upside down, because what I really don't want to do is I don't want to go out the other side. So then I can get the length, back it off a hair, that's a hair, and lock it down there. Yeah.
Perfect.
Sweet.
Oh boy.
No. Perfect. Hey, second one. We're already professionals at this. Say good morning, Mr. Hatch.
Good morning.
We are going to be doing some welding today. There's the other one. We're going over the side.
Over the side of the knee brace because the sun's right.
Sun's in his eyes. Really? You need somebody to hold an umbrella for you?
Umbrella girl.
Yeah, okay.
Right. Yeah, we'll work on that.
Okay, I'm going to
No, I did not get that. The first sweat of summer. Look,
I kind of bothered the knee.
Too much work. Not worth it. Yeah. All right.
Whee!
Little things in life, right?
Yeah. Okay, I've got pliers and...
Somebody under there. These guys are amazingly fast diggers. And a little aggressive too, just a little aggressive. Yeah, come here, let's bring you out in the light of day. Quit biting me. Yeah, come on, I'll let you get away. There you go, there you go. Look at him. Boy, he is ferocious. You are ferocious, look at that big mouth of yours. You're safe, the cat's not here. Well, man, watch him dig. I tell you what, that is amazing. Well, you're safe in my yard, I don't care. Well, unless the cat finds you, then you're gonna be dinner. Good luck there, little buddy. This thing is called a chock. They get welded in back here, and what its job is to do is to keep lines from breaking, because any toe line will go around it and have a nice soft radius. There's a good one. That's not the center mark. That's the center mark. All right, now I've got to do some welding.